Hey everybody, welcome to the Top 10 Most Awesome channel. For centuries, scientists have used biology to help understand life. Many phenomena that our ancient ancestors have attributed to the gods and spirits are now easily explained with biology. This important scientific field of study has helped us better understand ourselves and the world we live in. But despite the many advances we've made in biology, there are still some questions that even our best and most intelligent scientists can't answer. Today we will talk about the top 10 such biological mysteries that are still unexplained. On our number 10 spot, we have, why are other primates so much stronger than us? In many ways, human bodies are extremely similar to those of other primates like chimps. They have very similar muscle structures. Despite that, though our closest primate relatives are around 1.35 times stronger than we are, we developed more slow-twitch muscle fibers, which are less powerful muscle fibers than other primates. However, these muscle fibers do allow humans to have greater endurance than other primates. They enabled early human behaviors like hunting and foraging. Today, they are the reason a human can run a marathon while a monkey can't. But despite all those human perks, the strength disparity is still significant enough to baffle scientists. If you are feeling bad about your human weakness, have no fear. The human body still does plenty of incredible things every single minute. On the number 9 spot, we have dominating hand. 9 out of 10 people are right-handed. More mysterious than the dearth of southpaws is the fact that humans have dominant hands in the first place. Why just one hand with top-notch motor skills instead of a double dose of dexterity? One theory holds that handedness results from having more intricate wiring on the side of the brain involved in speech, which also requires fine motor skills. Because the speech center usually sits in the left brain hemisphere, the side wired to the right side of the body, the right hand ends up dominant in most people. However, this theory gets a big blow from the fact that not all right-handed people control speech in the left hemisphere, while half of lefties do. Perplexing. If you find the video interesting and full of curiosity, hit the subscribe button and become our squad. Also, comment down below which mystery is your favorite one. Moving to the number 8 spot, why do we pick our nose? Have you ever wondered why we pick our nose? Probably not, because there are far more important things in life to worry about than this disgusting behavior. Surprisingly, there are several scientists who are intrigued about nose picking and are working hard to discover the reason as to why we do it. Though it is considered taboo, almost all of Earth's population, whether in public or in private, is picking their nose. Nose picking is seen as a hygienic but disgusting act of removing nasal debris. This might seem like an excellent explanation as to why humans do it, but one study in 2006 showed that nose picking could potentially cause harm. People who pick their noses are more likely to become carriers of a certain nasty bacteria called Staphylococcus aureus than their non-picker counterparts. In other words, picking your nose can make you a spreader of bacterial infections. For some, nose picking has become an unhealthy and harmful behavior. A 53-year-old woman carved a hole in her sinus and nasal septum as a result of chronic nose picking. So why do humans still continue to pick if it's more harmful than helpful? Scientists still don't have an answer. Perhaps as trivial and disgusting as it is, this behavior is destined to remain an eternal biological mystery. Number 7 spot has something interesting, that is, why do we sleep? Despite many decades of research and many theories, science still can't explain why we sleep. We do know, more or less, what happens while we are asleep, but the main reason for it is still unknown. There are plenty of other life forms that never actually sleep, such as jellyfish, bacteria, plants, and sponges, for example. So why is it that higher animals have to sleep to stay sane, fit, and healthy? Our number 6 spot is about a weird case, the unexplained putrid finger. An unnamed Welsh man became the subject of an interesting but rather ridiculous article published in a Lancet after he accidentally cut his finger with a chicken bone. The man didn't die, but he suffered immensely. After he got cut, his finger started to smell. The odor was so terrible that it was comparable to rotten meat, and it lasted for 5 years. The incident happened in September 1991. At that time, the Welshman was 29 years old and was making a living by dressing chickens. When the man's wound became smelly and reddish, he went to Gwent Hospital in Newport, Wales to consult with 4 doctors. The physicians tried using different antibiotics, such as fluoxetine, ciprofloxacin, eresomelin, and metronidazole to get rid of the putrid smell. When that failed, they tried hand surgery, but this didn't solve the problem either. Over the course of half a decade, the doctors tried almost every solution: ultraviolet light treatment, probithine, colpramine, antibiotic withdrawal, sorlerin, and more. The physicians decided to publish the strange case in The Lancet with the hopes that some physician somewhere had encountered a similar problem and could suggest a way. After 5 long years of trying and failing, the putrid smell mysteriously vanished. Number 5 spot is very common, yet unexplained one: origin of life. It is not a question unique to science. Mankind has been attempting to answer this for many years, many millennia. Religious explanations aside, there are a myriad scientific theories about how we and every other living thing came to be. Ideas range from life being delivered to Earth from somewhere else to clay particles helping to create the first RNA strands. Whether or not we will ever be able to answer this is anyone's business, but it is certainly one of the most intriguing questions that science is attempting to answer. Just stop here and take a moment to like and share the video with as many people and give them food for thought. Also, hit the bell icon to never miss anything from us. On the number 4 spot, we have chimeric people. Imagine going for generic tests along with your children, only to find that you can't possibly be their biological mother, despite the fact that you gave birth to them. This isn't science fiction. It has actually happened to a few people around the world. In the case, it turned out that the mother was a chimera, a mix of 2 individuals. She was the composite of 2 non-identical twins that had fused in her mother's womb. No one knows how common chimeras are, but with the rise of fertility treatments and genetic testing, more chimeras are likely to be created and discovered. The number 3 spot is quite interesting. Why we cry? What scientists does know is that not all tears are created equal. The chemical composition of the tears produced when we cry, which are called psychic tears, is slightly different from the composition of the tears that lubricate and help expel foreign bodies from the eyes. This has led some to theorize that the chemical makeup of psychic tears makes them emotionally healing, but evidence showing that the chemical differences have substantial psychological effects, let alone that such effects explain why crying evolved, is lacking. And that's not where the theories end. Some evolutionary psychologists think that crying may have evolved as a distress call that brings help. In a 2009 paper, one researcher suggested that tears may signal submission and helplessness by blurred vision, which prompts others to aid, or at least not harm, the crier. But other researchers have pointed out that we often cry after a stressful situation has resolved, not while it's in progress and we need to signal for help. It's also typical for people to avoid crying publicly and to look unfavorably on those who do. In any case, these hypotheses, like most in evolutionary psychology, are difficult to test. The number 2 spot will literally make you think as well. What dreams are for? If the question of why we sleep is complicated, the question of why we dream is even more so. Dreaming, especially with vivid, fanciful dreams, is most correlated with rapid eye movement, or REM sleep, which itself is poorly understood. One thought is that dreaming evolved to help us sort out or rehearse solutions to problems in our waking lives, but there is no hard evidence that this is the case. Although our dreams may feel significant to us, it's also possible that they are severe no purpose. They may simply be a byproduct of other processes that occur during REM sleep. Studying the neurological basis of this strange and highly subjective experience of dreaming is complicated, which is why understanding the origin of dreaming is still beyond our grasp. And finally, on the number 1 spot of one of the big things science has yet to explain, consciousness and free will? This is a two-part mystery, and it's a doozy. The first one is easier to understand for most of us, and that's because it's about us. We are a self-aware species, and we are conscious. But what about consciousness, and where does it reside? Is a brain in a box still a person, and as much of a person as the brain was when it was in the body? There are a million questions that revolve around consciousness, and we're not going to sit around asking and answering them all. What's more important is that we don't fully understand consciousness and where it comes from. We have a huge gap to explain when it comes to jumping from atoms to cells to people and eventually consciousness. While most biologists will tell you that consciousness certainly has something to do with the brain, if not everything, we're having a hard time explaining how it is that certain living things that don't have brains are able to accomplish. For example, when you play back the sound of a caterpillar chomping on leaves, certain plants are able to hear that chomping somehow and react by letting off chemicals that attempt to ward off the caterpillars. How on earth can a plant do this without a brain? And how is it able to hear, let alone react, is a mystery. Are plants also conscious? That's all for today, guys. Do you agree with our picks? Check out some other of our clips for the top 10 most awesome and enjoy. I will see you in the next one.